from the RE/MAX Real Estate Concepts Studios. This is Webcast One Live.
Welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie. We are your hosts for this evening. This is David Waite and I'm Christine Waite. And we're filling in for Dave and Patty. They're on the road. They're in Virginia currently right now. They're traveling and have been traveling for quite a long time. And we expect they'll be traveling for another couple of weeks. They're actually available, and they're going to share with us what's been going on over these few weeks and what's been happening in Virginia. Hi, Dave and Patty.
Hi, Dave and Christine. That's kind of funny, isn't it? How are you guys doing?
Good.
We're good.
Good. Well, we're having a great time in the Lord. We're just going all over. Isn't that a cool picture behind us? That was a good place to set us, huh? And we have with us tonight Jerry and Renee. I'm sorry. Sometimes you have those kind of brains, you know. And we're staying at their home. We've done a life team group on Friday night, and then we were at two different churches, Pastor Brian Britton, one in Richmond, Virginia, and one in Williamsburg, Virginia, the dwelling place. And we had a great time at all places, and of course we prayed for people out and about in restaurants and in different people's homes too. So we just had a good time doing what God put in front of us. So can you tell us, Renee, what some of the things that you saw this weekend? Maybe we'd start Friday night so we can kind of keep track of it.
Okay. Friday night, we had our life team group, and we got some people activated, and we got them praying over other people that were in the group, some that were visitors. And We had one lady that actually came to one of the meetings afterwards, right? She came that night, and then she came again to one of the meetings. So that encouraged her to come on. And I'm not sure she brought any friends with her, but she was real excited to meet you all and to have you pray over her. I really didn't get a chance to talk to her to find out, you know, if she had experienced being set free from some of the things she was dealing with. But we had some other people that were prayed for at the life team. And we got one young lady that's really new to this, and she just jumped right in.
Yes, she did. And she did great.
Yes, she did. And I know she was a little apprehensive, but you guys were coaching her, and it really helped her to get just really get in and get to on the job. That's what was really exciting to see. And I think it's really going to help to propel this group forward. So we're excited that you all have been here. It's been great.
Yeah. And we were at Russell and Lori Vine's home.
Right.
They're the life team leaders here. And he's also the state director.
Yes, he is. Yes,
and then you and your husband are the life team group assistant leaders.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And so we try to go to the different life team groups so we can help them get pushed up into where they need to be and just get them fired up. And, you know, if there's other people that haven't been into this, when you have somebody new come in, then it brings them in. So it really can make the group bigger in the end.
Right. Right. And I think we'll see, since the beginning of the year, we've seen growth. And even so, I mean, like some of the other meetings, we connected with people that have been through DHTs, and they mm-hmm. didn't realize that we have groups out there that are doing this. So I think that is really good that we can bring them on in, and, you know, that'll help our groups to grow too.
Yes.
And then just the fact that they connect with other people.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that there's really other people out there
right.
that are doing the same thing,
yes.
that they're stepping into it, and that they can connect with other people. They can go out in the marketplace with other people,
right.
and they know that somebody else thinks the same way
right.
they do.
That helps a lot. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. So, do you remember any healings from Russell's house on Friday night?
Not specifically. I know we blasted a lot of people.
Yeah, we sure did. Yeah.
I remember the lady at the restaurant got filled with the Holy Ghost at the Olive Garden.
Yes, it seems like that happens a lot of places that we go. So it was neat. I remember Olive Garden, there was, it was the same lady. We asked her if we could pray for anything, and she said, oh, no, I don't need anything. And then she goes, oh, well, you can pray for my little boy. And so she just kind of walked away. And so I just started praying, and we prayed for her little boy and just for favor, and that God give her heart's desire. And I saw her, she stopped, she put her head down, and then she just kind of looked at me as I continued to pray. And you could just tell it blessed her, mm-hmm. you know, that people just care sometimes. It's not always that they get healed, but they just see Jesus in you because you're reaching out to them.
Right.
And yeah. and then after that, she was open, and she received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. So that was cool. And then we went and prayed for Kent's mom.
Yeah, that was on Saturday.
Yeah.
Let me add one more thing about the Olive Garden.
Yeah.
After you prayed for the young lady and she received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, she wanted to go and get her friend. And she brought her friend back to the table. You remember that? And she wanted to talk, and she was all excited. You know, and you could just tell, I mean, just the connection you have with people of faith, and they, mm-hmm. they want to be around other people of faith. And that was really exciting that, oh, yeah, let me go get my friend. And
yeah.
Over.
Yeah, that's good. Cool. And so Kent's mom, he really got fired up.
He went
to Russell's house. And he got fired up, and he went Saturday night and Sunday with us, and he just really got fired up, and he was excited to do the Lord's work and
yeah.
see it and really pray for multiple people, because we had you guys, you and your husband and your son come up,
right.
and everybody did a great job, and Kent and then Russell, he came up and prayed for people, and it was just cool because there was a big group of people, so you get
yeah.
to pray over and over and just see it, and it's like it pops like popcorn when you're in that kind of setting, and it's really exciting to see how the Lord moves,
right?
And we just love it. But oh, I gotta go back to Kent's mom. We went to her house, and she had a lot of pain. She didn't walk very well. She said she usually used a cane.
Yes, she did.
And she stood up straighter, and her leg grew out. It wasn't very far, but, you know, even a half an inch makes you walk crooked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so,
that's true.
Praise the Lord. And just all different things were moving around in her body, and she could really walk a whole lot better, and she had no pain anymore.
Right.
And she said she felt lighter.
She was amazed. I could tell.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was just really different from when we first came in mm-hmm. to when we left. And she was happy, a bubbly person anyhow.
Right.
But you could tell. She said, I feel lighter.
She was receptive.
Really
receptive.
Yeah. Do you remember anything about that, or what do you
she
want
just
to
didn't
tell?
Know what to do with me after she had telling her I've been dead, blind, and crippled, and I went on and on and on that. Anybody to hang around me very long, you either really, really don't like me or you really do. She was up running around, and I don't know, she kind of hit me about five different times. Oh, you're so funny.
Oh, that's funny.
She just thinks you were a hoot.
Yeah. Yeah, she just wasn't quite sure what to think of them. So we were at
What do you guys have going on?
Christine and Dave.
We've had another good report for the baby, Maya, that had been the shaken baby, and she was blind and a lot of damage done, and came off of life support and is alive and is seeing her mom. And so the family is just really thrilled. They, you know, what the doctor said was that they didn't expect that. They had much less expectation than what the family is experiencing. So we've been really excited about that. David had something happen at Cornerstone that I thought he should share.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I had the opportunity to pray for a woman. We actually prayed for her, I guess maybe about a month earlier. She went into the hospital, and she had blood clots in her lungs. And it's interesting how sometimes when you pray for people, you expect really good results, obviously, because, you know, you believe in what the Word says. And sometimes we don't realize the results we get. And I said to her son-in-law, I said, you know, I really believe that your mother-in-law was going to be healed completely. And he says to me, it was a miracle that she even came out of the hospital alive.
Amen.
And so I got a chance to pray for her. She has a very rare blood disease. She was going up to Mayo Clinic that Sunday, and I got a chance to pray for her with all sorts of people walking around. And as I prayed for her, the Holy Spirit came over her so strong that her daughter had to hold her up, and I held her up too to keep her from falling down right on the ground in front of us. And she was actually, her daughter and I actually helped walk her out of the church. She was so overwhelmed by the Spirit. Now, we haven't heard back as to the results, but I'm not pulling my faith back. I'm believing that she's going to be completely healed.
Amen. Good job. We love hearing all that good stuff.
That's a new experience for that church, I think, too. So it's just wonderful to be a testimony and a living example that God touches people even today.
Amen.
And that he loves them and he's with you when you're going through, no matter what you're going through, he's with you. And there are people who believe it and will lay hands on you and want to see you healed, because we know that God still heals today.
Amen. Amen. Sure does. And we sure like to be a part of that. We just really enjoy doing what we do. We just thank God that he allows us to do that, because, you know, it doesn't get a whole lot better than that. Maybe she could do it full time.
Yes.
Amen.
Someday you will, too.
I know. It's coming.
Yes. Yes, it is. Amen. Well, we have a video testimony from the pastor that we were at his two churches this last weekend. So, Ryan, could you play that for us? It's Pastor Ryan Britton from The Dwelling Place, and he had a church in Richmond, Virginia. Yep, there he is, and also in Williamsburg, Virginia.
In Williamsburg in Richmond, Virginia. And I just want to say how grateful we are to Holy Spirit-led Ministries for Dave and Patty for being with us. And we saw a slew of miracles over the last couple of days. They were in both of our churches. Up in Richmond last night, there we had so many people healed that we really lost track of it. And today here in Williamsburg, again, just another great time of the Lord. Lots of people healed. The power of God. The church is encouraged. So I want to wholeheartedly just recommend their ministry. It's such just a simple testimony of the goodness of God, the gospel, the power of God, the fire and life of Jesus Christ. And I don't know if we've seen it, the gospel displayed like this in such simplicity. Just the power of God on display ever. We're excited, and we endorse their ministry. God bless you. Thank you, Holy Spirit-led Ministries, and bless you as you minister around the country. You can contact us if you'd like more information about their ministry. Our website's thedwellingplacerichmond.com.
Yeah, he was really, really a neat guy, Pastor Brian. He really enjoyed what all he got to see, and so did his church. And the first time there was a whole lot of a whole lot of people that were there the first night, and they really just got it. And we'll show the next video on when we come back from commercial. There was a lady whose hip was healed. We told the LaDonna story, and oh my gosh, she just grabbed a hold of it. It was so cool. Ryan, can you do some of the pictures that are there that we talked about earlier? There's some of them at both churches, and you can see the pastor and his family. And there was just, you know, there was so much going on. It's hard to grab a hold of it and put it all on here. But that was the first night. Oh, there's your son. And Luke, thank you. There you are in the blue. And is your husband, can you see him up there?
He wasn't there.
Oh, okay. That's the one time he couldn't come. There, there's Russell bent over with his little girl standing right next to him to the right. He's the state director for Virginia. And there's Pastor Brian and his wife, Valerie, and their little girl, Anastasia. She helped sing the first night. And this is the second church that we were at of theirs on Sunday. And they're just my, it was good. God did so many things. And the first night when Dave asked people to come up front, it was just like popcorn. He was just blasting them as he went down the row. And some of them were kind of hitting the deck and getting healed of different things that they had wrong with them. And it kind of scared me because there wasn't anybody there to catch them. But, you know, God knows what he's doing, and nobody gets healed when it's God's idea. Although, as we're sitting there watching, nobody gets hurt when they fall down, is what I'm trying to say. Sorry. When God's doing the work. So that was just interesting because some of them really went flying, too. But
I see a lot of feet on the floor, Patty.
Yeah, and that was only part of it. We couldn't even get all of the pictures, and that's when the pastor took. So, yeah, there was a lot of people that needed to be healed and set free, and praise God they got it that night. There was just so many, and Dave just went through it first like he usually does and just boom, 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 boom. And then, you know, if they don't get it the first time, we pray again, and we had all the group come up and praying for people. And one of the littlest girls there, she got filled with the Holy Spirit, and I just love it when God does that because I know they have that for the rest of their life then. Mm-hmm. And can you think of any of the healings you prayed for some people that night?
Yes. I prayed for a woman who had neck problems and another one who had knee problems. And let's see. I'm trying to remember back. After a while.
How many miracles did you see this weekend?
I lost count. I'm sorry. I mean, I was just busy. So I wasn't just spectating. So that's the thing. And neither was my son. He jumped right in there, and that was probably one of the most exciting things.
And he's going to go with us the next couple months.
Well, I'm not even talking about it.
Yeah, so you're ready to let him go?
I don't know. He just turned 18. And he's been doing the DHT all along with us. And
yeah.
Now the Dominion Bible Institute. But more importantly, he's jumping in, he's laying hands, and he's seeing the results. So that's what's been very exciting this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
Probably the most dramatic thing all weekend would have been, for me, that I witnessed myself, would have been the lady with the hip. That she, you know, you're going to see her testimony, so it's better coming from her mouth.
Right, yeah.
But also the little girl that you talked about that was filled with the Holy Spirit, she was definitely delivered from something.
Yes.
That weekend, I mean, from the beginning of the service to the end of the service, there was just a complete change in this little girl.
Transformation, yeah, yeah.
And this little girl, it was very exciting to see. It was very dramatic, and it was very complete. I mean, by the end of the service, she was saying, Jesus loves me, And before, if you said Jesus, she was covering her ears.
Mm-hmm.
And she did not want to hear that, and she didn't want to look at anybody in the eye.
And
she was engaging people after that.
So. Yeah, she actually let me touch her later and let me pray for her again because she had an owie on her knee. So, oh, God, it's 7:20 already. I guess it's time for a commercial. And if we can come in, Ryan, with that lady, she has a red top on. It's like 4 minutes long. If we can come in with that first.
Okay.
Thank you.
Celebrate the light.
I was hungry. I was thirsty. I was a stranger. I was naked. I was sick. To the least of these, Holy Spirit-led Ministries is a proud supporter of Impact Ministries International, changing the world together. Find out more at tstammen.com.
Hi, this is Andy Hainer of Full Speed Impact. And if you're like me, the message you hear of God's miraculous power on this program builds your faith and encourage you to step out and touch others with God's love. That's why I'd like to share with you some exciting opportunities that Dave and Patty have right now to carry the work of Holy Spirit-led ministries forward in the area of television media, as well as some crucial requests to go into other nations, including Cambodia, India, Africa, and South America, to equip the church and to win the lost with the power of the kingdom of God and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I want to encourage you to partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries. Go to their website right now at hslm.us. Click on the donate button to make a tax-deductible contribution, and you will be blessed as you partner with this strategic work to carry the gospel of the kingdom of God into all the world. God is moving right now. Go to hslm.us and partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries today and be part of that move.
Anybody here that has been believing God for a healing? I mean, I have experienced a supernatural healing tonight like never before. At the age of 23, I was in a near-fatal car accident, and I actually had passed on. I didn't have an out-of-body experience or anything like that, but I had such severe injuries that I was on life support for a week. I had a crushed hip, broken ribs, punctured lung, ruptured spleen, and I had a four-year-old and a two-year-old at the time. I was so injured that they could not even do surgery to unmangle my hip at that time. They had to stabilize me for 2 weeks before they could go in and get all the bone fragments out. During that time, I had bone grafting done to where they took part of my hip up here and they bone grafted there, and I was in the hospital for 4 months. And someone else took care of my children during that time. I've been a believer since I was 18. But I'm here to tell you, all these years since that accident, I've had 5 hip surgeries. And in 2009, I had a total hip replacement. Through all those years, I kept saying, God, why am I not healed? I believed. I'm a worshiper. I prayed. I've had so many people pray for me. I've had so many times to where I'm like, this is it. This is going to be my day. I have gotten discouraged in life in the last few years, and God is bringing me back to his heart at this season in my life. I have suffered every single day with pain in my hip, my back, my neck. I get some migraine headaches from it. And I was sitting at the table with my husband this week, and we were talking about the Lord and the goodness of God. And I said, honey, I said, I believe that God can still heal me. In spite of it, I said, how much more of a testimony would it be with all this metal in me? The bone has been removed. How much more of a testimony would it be for God to heal me and restore new bone into me so that I could be a testimony of his goodness and his love? Because we're no respecter of person. I'm no different from anybody else, and I've known it all along that he is no respecter of person. And I'm here to tell you tonight, I'm telling you, I am healed. I could not do that. I'm telling you, I am free. My back is released. I feel taller. And all I can say is the joy of the Lord is my strength. I mean, my joy is back. Faithful, even when we're not. Yes. He is a good
good, God, and he's faithful. And I just give him all the glory, and I pray that somebody's heart right now will reach out to him, and you receive your miracle, because he's a miracle God. He is faithful to the end. He will complete the good work he started in every one of us.
Amen.
Welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie from Holy Spirit-led ministries who are traveling across the U.S. right now, training people up in the DHT, learning how to be divine healing technicians so that they too can lay hands and see the miracles of God be affected in people's bodies like the testimony we just saw. They're currently doing that right now in Virginia. I'm Christine Waite, and this is my husband, David, joining us so that we are here in Iowa in order that we can introduce Dave and Patty in Virginia so they can share the many miracles that they have seen as they've been traveling across the U.S. If you're looking to learn about DHT, go to the website, look them up, and find out where they are, and go join the party.
That's good. I like that, Christine. Oh, that's good. So what did you think in that last testimony?
Incredible. Incredible. You know, it doesn't ever get boring to hear the continued hope that gets put in people who have been standing in faith and believing, and they finally get to see God move because God's body is activated to do what they're supposed to do and what they've been created to do all along. Amen. It's so encouraging to see and hear. That's the vibrancy of the church. You can't say that Christianity is boring when you hear people with that much excitement say, I'm finally not in pain. I have my joy. I'm able to walk, run, skip, rejoice, and give a testimony and tell people that God is still doing miracles today. And you can learn how to do that. You can learn how to see that happen for people who are in pain and who are suffering, and you can set them free. There's no greater joy than that. How can Christianity be boring when you can see someone who has a need? I mean, David and I just walked to we went to a QT or a come and go, and we saw a woman getting out with a walker, and you could tell she was burdened and heavy and in pain, and I could not walk away. You can't walk away when you know that God is available to heal them. And so you have no shyness, no nothing. You just walk right up and say, God wants to touch you today. Can I pray for you? And we were able to just pray for her right there in the parking lot, right, honey?
Amen. What's easier, to tell them about Christ or to show them what Christ is like?
So did you pray for her?
Yes, we did. Yes. She got touched. And then she said she was in a hurry to go to work, but she really got touched by the Lord. And it was just, it's wonderful to know that. And you don't really even have to wait to see the miracle because you already know God loves that person probably more even than you do. And he's willing to transform their life because it's his name and it's his love and it was his plan in the first place. And so just letting yourself go and saying, I trust that God wants to, and the Holy Spirit already knows Jesus paid for this. Holy Spirit is going to do what Jesus already paid for. So you already know it's already done. You just have to invite it to take place.
Amen. Amen. You're awful quiet tonight, Dave. What did you see?
She's asking you what you've seen.
I'm sorry.
What have you seen? She said you're quiet.
Oh, what have I seen? I don't know. We've kind of had a quiet week, so I'd have to go back in what we've seen. But we have a woman who's committed to be in our life group on Thursday nights, and she's gone through, I think, 10 of the DHT videos that we're showing her, and she's already working on praying for people and seeing people getting healed. She's caught a hold of it immediately because we have prayed for people in our group, and she's seen how we do it and this type of thing. And it's just exciting to see how you can, you know, reproduce this same thing over and over again. And the more people that we get to go do it, you know, the more the kingdom of heaven is going to come to earth.
Amen.
She's been bold. Her neighbors don't necessarily know the Lord. They're learning now because she hears that they have headaches or pain. One of them had a problem with their hand. And she just says, let me pray for you because God wants to heal you. And they go, really? You can do that? They didn't even know. And so she goes ahead and does it, and they get healed. And so now what's happening is her neighbors are coming back and saying, oh, today I hurt this, or this other thing happened, and can you pray for this? So they know where to come for help. They know that Jesus is healing them, and they're getting a taste of how God moves and how God operates. And Lila's just really excited because she's praying for people who are going through difficulties in marriage, and they're encouraged. And so now they call more, and they say, I know I can call you because you'll pray for me.
Amen. Praise God. That's cool. Well, good job, you guys. Well, now we have Jerry with us, and he was at the Friday night meeting and Sunday. Tell us some of the things that you remember, or if you have other testimonies that you want to share, whatever you want to share.
Well, one we went to Sunday in Williamsburg, I got a chance. We had a family who's, patriarch was struck with cancer. He's mid to late 80s, we've known. Just a great encouragement to my family and myself. And we'd let them know that we were going to be there at that church, and they actually brought him out. So I had a chance to visit with him and catch up on just some times that we'd lost and being able to talk to one another. So, we all share in the same spirit. And I was just, I guess what struck me, although my wife and I have been walking in the divine healing for some time, a couple of years at least. I think the Lord had spoke to me more beyond that, and what's being done here, which is the introducing people to the fact that they are new creatures in Christ, there's no nature inside fighting with that nature that you have. I mean, basically, you're a new creature, and you just have to renew your mind to that. And so, for me, I watched a lot of people pray and ask the Lord for revival, when in fact it's all dependent upon us. I mean, you need enough people acting the way Christians really act.
Amen.
You've got revival, essentially. And so, what I see Dave and Patty doing is also bringing that along. Much of the time, it's the healing that's emphasized, but there's actually a lot going on in terms of the way people think, in terms of their relationship with Christ and who they are in Christ, which to me is a very powerful thing, too. So I had a chance visiting with this brother that I hadn't seen in probably, a year and a half, something like that, I think. And so I enjoyed that. Had a chance to see Dave, pray for him, curse the tumor. His ears were opened.
Praise God.
So a lot was being done. I saw a lot of people healed. And Dave always asked them, do something you couldn't do before. And if they needed to be hit again, he'd go ahead and speak to that, whatever that was, again.
Amen.
We did get a chance Sunday morning. I had not cleared it for Dave to actually do anything, but I took him to our church in Powhatan, went to Family Worship Center. Tammy and Don Habersack are the pastors there, husband and wife. Mm-hmm. And it was amazing. Again, we all share the same spirit. Pastor Don had an elder there at the church. Bob, I'm sorry, his last name escapes me right at the moment, but he led right into what Dave was asked to do. Dave didn't come there other than just to kind of sit there with my family and I and worship the Lord and just experience what we experience in the church. But that Pastor Don had asked him to come up afterwards. And at the time, we'd been going through some things where we believe maybe that there's some people that feel like their ability to worship and their ability to be accepted by God is dependent upon them. And Bob just a very powerful message about how nothing is dependent upon us. It's all dependent upon God.
Yeah.
And in fact, that there's no condemnation through Christ. And
right.
He does what the Father, what he sees the Father do. So all of that condemnation was long ago. And even God is not condemning. He's looking for someone to believe. So if you go to hell, it's not because you're a murderer or anything like that. It's because you didn't believe.
Yeah. We got to take a break right now. Yes, amen. Thank you. We have to take a commercial break here. And so we'll be right back. Thank you, Jerry.
God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are. Let me ask you something. Is the fivefold ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you. What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
Hi, this is Andy Hainer of Full Speed Impact. And if you're like me, the message you hear of God's miraculous power on this program builds your faith and encourage you to step out and touch others with God's love. That's why I'd like to share with you some exciting opportunities that Dave and Patty have right now to carry the work of Holy Spirit-led ministries forward in the area of television media, as well as some crucial requests to go into other nations, including Cambodia, India, Africa, and South America, to equip the church and to win the lost with the power of the kingdom of God and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I want to encourage you to partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries. Go to their website right now at hslm.us. Click on the donate button to make a tax-deductible contribution, and you will be blessed as you partner with this strategic work to carry the gospel of the kingdom of God into all the world. God is moving right now. Go to hslm.us. and partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries today and be part of that move.
Welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie. I'm Christine Waite. This is my husband, David Waite. And we are here simply to connect you with Dave and Patty, who are traveling in Virginia and sharing their incredible stories. We've heard so many miracles already. It's amazing how quick this hour goes. Dave and Patty.
Hello. Well, we want to pray at this time, and I'm just going to let Jerry, if you don't mind, start out whatever the Holy Spirit puts on your heart, if there's somebody that you know that needs prayer, and then if you want to follow up Christine, and then Dave Waite, if you just want to finish it out, and we'll just, whatever you guys know that needs to be done. And if somebody would pray for Dan, he's a friend of ours that has cancer, and hopefully he will be coming tomorrow night to see you guys at the house. So whatever God puts on your heart. Go ahead, Jerry.
All right. Well, now I want to speak to Dave's body, you know, that he would be healed now, that his body would come into alignment with God's word now in Jesus' name. I lift up... Shane, I pray that that he would be healed, that all the situation that he's in right now would go and dissipate in Jesus' name. I lift up Bill, the cancer in his body. I curse it now in Jesus' name and command it to leave.
Amen.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Father God, we thank you right now for baby Maya, for the healing, for bringing her into full life, for healing her brain, and that swelling is finished in Jesus' name, and her eyesight fully restored. We thank you for that, Lord. And we lift up Terry, who couldn't be with us tonight. Terry, be healed in the name of Jesus from head to toe, inside and out. Whatever tried to take effect, we cancel it now in Jesus' name. Your body be fully restored, fever, go. And you be set free and restored back, because we need you in the camp and we need you keeping the ministry going forward, Terry. So God bless you.
I just pray for Peggy that I would command those blood cells to become whole and normal now in the name of Jesus, and that she would be healed completely from the bottom of her feet to the top of her head in Jesus' name.
And every baby that's out there that needs a touch from God, Lord, touch them, move in their bodies, set them free. We break off the effect of the enemy right now in Jesus' name. For all those orphans, Lord, that need to know they're adopted by Father God, touch them now across the world, Lord. Give them comfort.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you very much, guys. Good job. And I just wanted to say, over the last 3 days, we've just been, you know, in so many different places, and we just thank God for allowing us to be there and be used. And there's been over 100 people that have been healed in the last 3 days. So we just praise God, you know, that He uses us, and we just love doing what we're doing. And there was just so many people. Wasn't there one you were talking about, honey, that you thought was a big one?
Oh, there's a little girl in a wheelchair. It looked like she was a crippled little girl anyway. She's all wound up, kind of like the lady down there in Texas. And she didn't get right up, but she started speaking. She started, she wasn't doing me at first. I only ministered to her a few minutes, and pretty soon she was giving me a high five, and I had her pray for me. And I believe she's going to continue to unwind.
Amen. Amen. Me too. And there was just so many people that really got activated this weekend that, you know, just really stepped out. Dave and I, we just pull people up, you know, even if they haven't gone through the DHT before, we pull them up and just have them lay hands on people and see that they can do it too. That, you know, it's no special anointing. You just have to have the anointed one that lives inside of you, Jesus. And you know what? You just release the Holy Spirit on somebody, and you just watch them be healed. It's just an amazing thing to see. It just never, never gets old. You know, when that lady was talking about her hip that was healed, we talked about LaDonna and her healing in her hips, how, you know, she had pins and metal, and the doctor had put them in, and they went in, and they actually saw the x-rays of now there was no metal, no pins, just normal body parts in her x-rays. And that lady was sitting over there as I was telling this testimony, and she was just crying and crying and crying. And I'm thinking, oh, God's really touching her. I've never seen anybody do that before. Well, then I knew why later, because she knew it was her day to be healed, that it was her time. Mm-hmm. And she received her healing. And I tell you, that was just amazing, amazing. We just never get sick. I've seen people that are sick get healed, and we just praise God that He does use us. And we do have a bunch of more DHGs coming up, so check out our website. And if
you're a church or if you're a group, and you want to learn more about this, you want to know how to do it, give us a call, send us an email, Holy Spirit Led Ministries at gmail.com. And if you can just put that up there, Ryan, Holy Spirit Led Ministries at gmail.com, so they can contact us. We're going to be in the East Coast for a little while here. We have been for about 3.5 weeks, and we're going to be going to Newcastle, Delaware this weekend, and then over to Massachusetts, hopefully, actually 2 different weekends in a row we'll be there. So praise God. And in November we'll be, or December we'll be on the West Coast, so, and we'll be in Missouri and Arkansas in November. So praise God, you know, he's just opening up the doors all over the place. I think we'll be in Pennsylvania coming up here really quick too. So praise God, he's just opening up the doors everywhere. And, you know, if you want to walk in this, give us a call. There's people that are sick that are out there that we're not going to be able to reach. And you know what? We were just talking about it today. And you know what? It's a matter of life and death in some cases. If you don't learn this and you don't lay hands on people that you know, they're not going to make it. Mm-hmm. And so it really is important. It really is a matter of time. You know, there's the ones from Pennsylvania that want us to come. They have somebody that is really in poor shape right now. And so they get it. It's time. They're not going to mess around anymore. They're going to get it done. So praise God. Don't waste any time. And it is available online on our website. Holy Spirit Led Ministries, or it's hslm.us. Thank you, Ryan. We have the DHT online, and obviously John G. Lake Ministry, Curry Blake, jglm.org. They have the training online too. So if you want to go through it online, grab this message so people that you know don't have to be sick and they don't have to die. Praise God.
Amen. I also want to encourage all those who have been taking the DHT with Dave and Patty. If you've been through a DHT, go online, sign up, and do the monthly reports, whether it's one person you've prayed for or 20. Because when you complete that and you go through the 3 months, you realize how much you're actually doing for God. It not only encourages you, but you get to report and give a testimony of what God has been doing in your neighborhood through you. And it really strengthens you, and it also reminds you that, you know, maybe it's time to go out and pray for somebody else so you can put it down in your report. But I want to tell you that after you do that for 3 months and you become certified, you really step into a new level in the spirit. You can feel the difference. There'll be a shift and a change because you not only took the DHT, but you did something with it and you were diligent with it, and God honors that. And it's really an incredible experience. David and I have done that, and you know, sometimes we say, okay, I'm going to do it, but then we just don't take the time. I'm telling you, it is very much worth it. And we want to know where you are, because we have loved ones all across the U.S., and you might be someone that's close to someone we love that needs prayer and needs healing. So we want to be able to reach you, and that's one of the ways that we can do that.
Yep. We've just been connecting people all over the United States, and praise God, we've had story after story where we've had people, we're doing a DHT, and they have a loved one that is, we're in South Carolina, and their dad's in Florida. And, you know, we stopped the DHT. We had a corporate prayer right then and there. Her dad was in really bad shape. They were on the way to the hospital. We called a good friend of ours, Cedric, in Florida. And within an hour and a half, he was there laying hands on that man. And praise God, that man is alive today. They did not expect him to live. They didn't. But you know what? God did. And Amen. He just had the right person at the right place at the right time. And you know what? It's so cool because we've done this over and over and over. we know so many people, but yeah, we want to know more people because we want somebody, no matter where it is, that needs healing, that they're going to get their healing because there's somebody there to connect and there's somebody there to go to the hospital or go wherever they need to go to lay hands on them. You know, the pastors, I just try to get this across to them because, you know, it's their flock, it's their church, it's their people that are sick. And they're responsible for them, too, to God, because as a pastor. And they need to step into this. They need to have the training, not just for them, but their people. And, you know, if the whole church goes through this training, they're not going to be such a pull on the pastor because they're going to be able to step up and they're going to be able to do it. They can help the pastor. It's not going to have to just be the pastor that goes to the hospital when somebody's sick. It can be just a member of the congregation because they can all be walking in it. And you know what? If everybody in all the churches, all the Christians were all healed and whole, can you imagine how people that were sinners that didn't know Jesus would be like, you know what? There must be something to this. I must be missing something somewhere. And they want to be whole too. They want to be healed. And if they realize all these Christians are walking in this, what do they have that I don't have? Jesus.
Amen.
So I just want to spread this throughout the world. And if you're not filled with the Holy Spirit, just receive that. The Holy Spirit is a gift from God. And you know what? There's nothing better. He helps guide you. He helps you have a discerning spirit to know and just to do the right thing. And you know what? It's just a gift that God has given us. And I just want to speak life into people right now just to receive that. Yes. You know, whether you need a healing or you just want to be filled with the Holy Spirit, reach out right now. God's there and he's waiting for you. Just ask that the Holy Spirit just touch you right now in Jesus' name, that you just receive it. You'll never be the same. You'll never be the same in Jesus' name. So we want to thank Dave and Christine for filling in for us tonight. And for when we're gone, that you guys help with the Tuesday nights and all that you do and other churches. You guys are just all over the place. You're such a blessing. So we just want to thank you guys.
It's our pleasure.
Hey, Dave, you'd love to be there. They were shaking and baking and flying through the air.
Well, come the end of October, I'm hoping to be there with you.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
You're going to go to Pennsylvania?
Or wherever you're going to go, I'm going to take a couple trips with you.
But he can't be gone as long as you guys are, okay? Because you're forgetting about us now. You're all over the whole United States. We don't see you anymore.
We left good people in charge.
Amen.
And you guys did a great, great job tonight. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Our pleasure.
We love it. We get to sit and hear all the miracles. It's wonderful. It's a big uplift to a Monday, you know. There's nothing better on a Monday.
I know. Norm is like, I love to come. Well, then she gets to see us because otherwise we're not there. And we like to see you guys too. So it's nice to have you there. Oh, and we want to thank Michael. He works with our website and he makes us look a whole lot better than what we could ever even imagine. He's such a blessing. And Ryan, he does such a good job all the time doing all these things that it's like on the spot. He's good. Praise God.
Thank you, Ryan.
And Terry's back home, and we're just speaking life into him. We just continue to pray for him, and we know God's working right now in Jesus' name. And Jeff, he's going to be coming out here with us this week.
Oh, wonderful.
Come to Delaware. I know he's excited about it, and we're looking forward to see him out here with us. That's going to be fun.
Already on the bus.
Oh, he's leaving tomorrow. I already texted him about it. So he'll be there Wednesday afternoon. And so we just want to thank you all at home. And we wanted to thank Jerry and Renee. I'm sorry. Sometimes I'm just so bad with names. We've stayed with them for a few days now, and they've just blessed us in such a way. And we just want to leave a blessing on their home. So, and we just, most of all, we want to say thank you to God because he allows us to do this. And so we'll see you next week, same time, same place, and more miracles.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless.
God bless. Good night.